JR Country.
Hey, Barbara, Travis Denny here.
Hi, how you doing, Travis?
I'm doing good. How about yourself?
Excellent, not too bad. Thank you so much for talking to Vancouver and the JR family. Have you ever been up to this neck of the woods?
So I connected through Vancouver on the way to Hamilton for the CCMAs one year.
Okay.
And as we were coming into Vancouver, like, I gotta be totally honest with you, I did not know Vancouver was so big. I mean, yeah, I knew it was like obviously a prominent city and all that. And I grew up snowboarding, so I've always wanted to go to Whistler.
And
I know that's up kind of in, like on the west coast over there near y'all.
Yeah.
But man, Vancouver skyline might be the prettiest I have ever seen in my life.
Well, that's what happens. People see it and they don't want to leave.
I was sitting there connecting and I'm thinking, oh, I want to stay the night. I want to hang out for a day. It looks so awesome.
And also Whistler, by the way, is only like an hour and a half, 2 hour drive from here. It's not that far.
Right. It's really close, I've heard. I mean, so I love like backcountry kind of snowboarding, like through the trees, you know, hiking up. And I've always been told that Whistler is probably the greatest mountain in the world for that stuff.
Well, you got to put that one on the bucket list, my friend.
It's at the top of the bucket list.
Travis, is there something about Canada that you've always been curious about that I can answer for you?
You know, honestly, I guess the only thing that I can think of is, like, how early do kids start playing hockey? Is it, like, 2 months old? Is that really when y'all start playing hockey?
Pretty much, yes. As soon as they can hold on to that stick, yeah, they're in.
My tour manager he's born and raised in South Florida, like, almost near Miami. And he is the biggest hockey fan in the world. Like, I've never met someone who was born and raised almost as far away from Canada as you can be in the United States who is the most Canadian-American guy I've ever met in my life.
Have you met Dierks Bentley? Because he's a huge hockey fan.
Oh, yeah. And he is a huge hockey guy. I know a lot of his band is, too. I actually, for the first time in my life, earlier this year, we played in Minnesota. And I laced up and I got out. And I shot some hockey a little bit. I'm gonna tell you right now, it wasn't pretty. It was not pretty at all, but I did it.
You shot some hockey, huh? Okay.
Yeah. Is that not the best part of the process?
No, I love it. That's awesome. Oh, Dan. Well, okay. Enough hockey talk, Travis. Let's talk about your music for a second, because you've been writing hit songs for people like some big dudes. Like we got the Aldeans, we got Justin Moore, Chase Rice. But now this is your time to shine. And I read somewhere that you were so amazed to see all of your hard work finally paying off.
Yeah, it's just so crazy to think, especially during this time. You know, of course, it would be my luck that when I finally have a top 15 in Canada and a top 10 in the United States that I can't leave the house. You know,
right.
That's definitely my luck. No, I mean, just sitting here and thinking back to, you know, when I first got my first songwriting deal, that was in 2014. I signed my record deal in 2017. And just to be able to look back on, it's really wild. And it's been so rewarding. Work is finally starting to pay off.
And you've got that new EP coming out in May, Beers Better Cold.
I mean, I don't like hot beers.
You know, but I think
everybody can relate.
Oh, no. After a Few is the new, it's your new track that we're playing here in Vancouver. It's a song that you co-wrote, but what was the inspiration behind that track?
Oh, man, I mean, the inspiration just really came out of, you know, that same old song and dance that kind of everybody's been through in their life. I think everybody's had one person in a relationship where it takes a couple key turns to finally end it, you know, and it takes a couple times for you to realize, all right, I got to move on. You're no good for me. And sometimes a few text messages or a few drinks or whatever it is kind of sends you right back into their arms. And I know I've definitely been there. Both of my co-writers have been there. And we're like, all right, let's tell our story here.
People are connecting with it.
Yeah, it's been amazing, yeah.
I know you're supposed to be on tour with Sam Hunt this summer, but it's been postponed for reasons, you know. How are you spending your time in isolation right now, Travis?
Man, I'm trying to really stay creative, mainly. Still writing a lot of songs, trying to record here and there, just, you know, little home studio set up, and just trying to keep the wheels rolling, you know, since we can't roll them on the bus, so we might as well roll them creatively, and trying to stay worked out on that, you know, and just stay creative and hopefully have some songs and something good come out of all this time that we've been given.
How how is the hair looking? Or have you attempted a quarantine cut yet?
The hair is looking not great, I'll be honest with you. It's a little sideways. My neckline is just all kinds of busted right now. I mean, I don't even know what's happening back there. I have trimmed up my sideburns because they started to get a little twiny. You know what I mean? Like a little, you ever seen like an old wicker chair that's starting to kind of fray
out?
Oh,
not a good look. No.
Yeah, it's not a good look at all. So, but I haven't cut it yet, mainly because I kind of like my long hair. So I kind of like it, you know?
You could always turn it into like a mullet. You can always go head-to-head with Morgan Wallen and try to out-mullet that guy.
I know. He's like a good couple miles ahead of me in that race, so I might just let him win that one. I don't even know if it's worth attempting, but I could just go for the mullet.
Well, Travis, Danny, what about banana bread? Are you baking up a storm like everybody else these days?
I haven't baked anything, but God, I love banana bread. Now that you said that, I may have to try that tonight. I have been, we've been cooking a good bit, you know, trying to eat healthy. It's not going well at all. Eating a lot of cupcakes at like noon,
yes.
You know? And, yeah, but not everything's going pretty good. God, banana bread sounds so good. Now that you say that.
This is the thing everybody's baking, like number one thing on Instagram. You see hashtag banana bread. Last week it had 1.5 million people use that hashtag, but by now it's probably triple that. Travis, I'm assuming you're quarantining with your girlfriend. What are you learning about each other that now that you're spending so much more time together? Or what is she learning about you that she was like, I didn't know that about you till now?
Well, she thinks I'm a picky eater because I don't like mustard. Like, literally, that's it. I love eating anything, but I'm just not a big mustard guy. And I don't like certain condiments. You know, now that we've been spending more time together, it's more opportunities to get on each other's nerves.
Of course.
And so, if I make a sandwich for like the sixth time and I don't put mustard on it, she's like, you're picky. You're a picky eater. So she thinks I'm a picky eater. I mean, honestly, we're kind of like an old married couple right now. We're both like, you know, we love each other and all, but it's like we're aggravating each other. So I think she's super fired up for me to maybe go back on the road as soon as possible and give her some free time. But in all seriousness, we've just been enjoying the time that we have together right now and the time that's been given and trying to find a little good in all of it.
What's a song right now, Travis, that's really cheering you up?
Oh, in all honesty, the entire new Dua Lipa album that came
out.
Oh, it is so good. It is just like full-on classic kind of pop music. Like, I don't know. It's really good. It's got killer grooves, killer beats, and some great songs. So if we get a couple beers in us, we usually get the Dua Lipa record going, and we're pretty fired up.
Wow. Now, what about the dance moves? You got those down, too?
No, I do not. And that's actually one thing I don't plan on trying to get down. If I start dancing, people start getting scared and running away.
But this would be a great time to perfect those moves now that, you know, you're on lockdown for the time being.
That's true. I might just have to put on my dance shoes later and give it a shot.
Well, now that the year's on hold, what are you looking forward to here in 2020, Travis Denning?
Looking forward to summer. Looking forward to some warmer weather.
What is the first thing you're going to do when you're allowed to break free? When we're allowed to go back outside and play? What's the first thing you're going to do?
100% truthful. The first thing I'm doing is going to a Mexican restaurant and drinking 3 margaritas and eating every bowl of chips and salsa they got.
That's a great plan.
Absolutely.
We've got some great Mexican restaurants here in Vancouver. You may be surprised to know. And I hope we can guide you to one eventually when you make your way over here to the West Coast.
Absolutely. When we come there for a show, we'll get some Mexican food, and maybe I may just have to kind of conveniently plan that West Coast trip around maybe some snowboarding season and find my way up in Whistler.
I think you should, man. Thank you so much for talking to Vancouver. I appreciate your time, Travis.
Yeah, thank you so much, and take care. Y'all be safe.
Good luck with the banana bread.
Take care. Thank you.
JR Country.